Okay, good morning to all, and I welcome you in Mr. Khan Academy. Today I'm going to cover the 2.11th video under the second series, Voice Coil Actuator. Before starting this video, I request you all my new viewers, jisne abhi tak mera channel subscribe nahi kiya, please subscribe my channel to motivate me to make such video in future also. Or you can check my channel also. On my channel, the subscribe button, this button is available. Okay, you can click over here and you can check my all latest video. There is the introduction of mechatronics, the series is available regarding the DC motor, the series is available, stepper motor, AC induction motor. Before starting this, you can check my previous two videos, that is 2.9 dry methods and 2.10 AC induction motors, which is just recently I uploaded. Hit the like button, share this video with your friends also, those who need it, those who want to learn regarding the voice coil actuator, say electrical actuator system. And if you want required the latest link of my previous video, you can check on my this card icon. On this link, this video links are available. Before starting the last coil actuator, you can check my all 10 videos which I shown on my channel. This 10 videos are under the second series regarding this DC motor, stepper motor, AC induction motor. Okay, latest 5 video links are available over here. The 2.9, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. And today I'm going to cover only voice coil actuator. Now, what is a voice coil actuator? Voice coil actuator is a kind of actuator which moves the mass along a line. Means, अभी तक हमने जो भी actuators consider किया, use किया या explain किया regarding the stepper motor, DC motor, AC motor, these are the circular motion, circular move होता है. If suppose I required a motion along a line, then that time I can use a voice coil actuator. It is a direct drive, limited motion device that use a permanent magnet field and coil winding to produce a force that is a proportional to the current applied to the coil. Means whatever the force produced, it because of field coil and current carrying coil or conductor. Originally used for the loudspeaker, the application of voice coil actuator, we are using the loudspeaker for the conversion of electrical energy into sound wave. For electrical energy sound wave convert karna hai through using the diaphragm. Then in the loudspeaker, we are using the voice coil actuator. It is the simplest type of electrical motor. The construction parts, there are two parts. One is a casing, which is a magnetic housing, and the coil, also called as a holder. By applying a voltage across the terminal of the motor, causes the motor to move of one direction. Means whatever the voltage we are applying to coil, as the coil carrying the current and magnetic flux, that current magnetic flux cuts that current carrying conductor, it generates the force, and because of that we are getting one direction moment. If I reverse the polarity, agar main polarity reverse karta hu, then we are getting opposite direction moment. The generated force is proportional to the current that flow through the motor. Then whatever the force is generated, that value totally depends upon the current, because magnetic flux value is fixed because of the permanent magnet. Now just take this simple example, how the motion we are getting. Then just assume this is a current carrying conductor which is moving from right to left. The field is there, magnetic field, which is perpendicular to the screen, okay, away from the our user direction. And if I apply the Lemmings left hand rule, the middle finger shows the direction of current, index finger shows the direction of flux, then thumbs will show the direction of motion. Then according to this figure, the force will be downward. If I reverse the current, instead of right to left, if I make to left to right, the force will be upward. It's called as a Lorentz force, which is a product of induction in current. Based on that, we are getting the force. In the diagram previous, whatever shown, the direction is downward. If I reverse the current, it will be upward. I explain. If the wire were free to move, it would accelerate towards the downward all along its length. Since the permanent magnet flux density field is fixed and direction of linear displacement depends on the polarity of current, I explain. So I am using the permanent magnet. Then flux density is fixed. We cannot vary the flux. Flux fixed rahega. Then whatever the force is totally depends upon the force, okay, because this value is fixed. Now this is an animated video, okay, regarding the how the voice coil actuator move. This is a housing, yeah, casing, you can say. This is a holder. On this holder, the coil is there, okay. If you see the cross section, then this is a hollow holder. Inside again the part of casing is there. This is a E-shaped type casing in which permanent magnet is there. And on this holder, this is a holder, the coil is mounted. If you want to see in a 2D diagram, then it will look like this. If I intersect completely, this is a 1/4 section. If I do the 1/2 section, it look like this in a side view. The E section holder, the casing, sorry, the sliding, which is a coil holder, inside the coil is mounted. Now just see one by one how it's work. Might be you're not getting through the animation. Yeah, through the principle. We'll see in detail through the animation how it works. Then let's apply. Let's assume the forces, the flux here is moving upward. Here is flux is moving downward, and the force is generated because of current. Now current is perpendicular to our screen. It will be not visible. Then let's rotate the image. Okay. Now the current is visible here in upward. The current is moving away from our screen. Here current is moving towards the screen because it closed loop. Here is moving inside, then here it will burn outside. Then if I apply the Fleming left hand rule, the middle finger current, index finger flux, then thumb show the direction towards left. And similarly same over here also, at current direction is reverse because of the flux direction also reverse. Here also it's showing the towards left, then it will move towards left direction. If I reverse the current polarity, then the force direction will be reversed and it will move towards right direction. Okay, I hope you understood. Let's repeat one more time. If the current is moving here away from the screen, here towards the screen, then here the flux is downward, here the flux is upward. If I applying the Fleming left hand rule, if index finger shows the flux, middle finger shows the current, then thumb shows the direction of force, which is towards left. If I apply the same rule over here, as the current direction changes, the flux direction also changes, but force remain same position. Then it moves towards the left direction. If I reverse the polarity, then it moves towards the right side. That is a complete principle of voice coil actuator. Now see the advantages versus the advantage of voice coil actuator is simplicity of construction. We are not using any kind of gear. They are completely silent and there is no backlash when the direction is reversed. And this is free. Now for the reference purpose, I just use the voice coil actuator and application guide, the PDF file, BEI Motion System Company, Kimco Division, 1992. The PDF file is available on Google. Just search this application of guideline BEI Motion System. You will get voice coil actuator PDF. By referring that, I just made this video. Thank you very much for watching this complete video. You can check my last two videos, that is 2.7 principle operation of stepper motor and 2.1 electric modeling of energizing coil, or you can go through my channel to check my all those video. Please hit the subscribe button, share this video with your friends also, hit the like button, and please hit the subscribe button to motivate me to make this video in future also. Thank you very much. See you soon. Bye bye. Take care.